The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
General, what do you think about the FBI saying that there's a terror alert on Monday about a potential Fort Hood situation?
The police are shoving people, shoving Alex, shoving the crowd.
Here we go, folks, I'm being assaulted.
Whether it's the radio show, the news websites, documentary films, or the nightly news, InfoWars is the tip of the spear.
Is this another false flag stage attack to take our civil liberties and put more homeland security while sticking our hands down on pants on the streets?
It's up to us to set brush fires in the minds of men and women everywhere. And that's what PrisonPlanet.tv is designed to do.
You watch the Assad regime is going to be blamed or accused of using chemical weapons against the so-called rebels.
What we see now is a war against reality. It's a war against the truth.
It's more vital than ever that supporters of freedom become members of PrisonPlanet.tv and share their membership with up to 11 friends and family. Visit InfoWarsNews.com today. Become a member, share your membership, and help take the InfoWar to the next level.
I don't know what it is. Ralph just won't pay any attention to me. When he comes home from work, all he ever does is play video games and go to sleep. It's like I don't even exist.
Oh, Betty, that's just awful.
Does this seem familiar? If the answer to this question is yes, then listen carefully. Toxic pesticides, GMO foods and additives, BPA plastics, contaminated water supplies, many of these toxic additives are deliberately engineered to attack and weaken human masculinity. It's part of the eugenics population control movement. Look it up. If men are more interested in online gaming than they are in their wives, a serious population crisis is soon to follow. Energize the man in your life with Super Male Vitality from InfoWarsLife.com. It's designed to aid the body in ways that help invigorate your natural systems without artificial testosterone, completely free of GMOs, harmful additives, gluten, and is made right here in the USA. Get your Super Male Vitality right now at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
A chemical spill contaminating the water supply in 9 West Virginia counties.
This year alone, over 300,000 people in West Virginia had their drinking water contaminated.
What are the health effects of having these drugs in our drinking water?
It's forced medical treatment without the consent of residents.
My friends, water filtration is one of the most basic actions you can take to protect you and your family from the harmful toxins and heavy metals in your tap water.
On average, the county says it sprays with the glyphosate at least once a week.
Few filters cut out the glyphosates that is found in water supply worldwide. Remove pesticides, herbicides, chloramines, hydrofluorosilicic acid, sodium hexafluorosilicate.
Fluoride, it is in tea, it's in coffee, it's in water, it's in bread, it's in toothpaste.
It is our responsibility to protect our families. The establishment's not going to do it. It's time to take action. It's time to filter our water. Visit InfoWarsStore.com and use promo code WATER to get 10% off their entire family of incredible products. Or call toll free 888-253-3139. The country is wide open. Borders are being lowered. Globalism is being launched in full scale.
If you are receiving this transmission, you are the resistance.
New Army and Air Force.
From the InfoWars.com studios, it's Alex Jones.
Army and Air Force recruits, we've got our reporters digging into this, are being told their next stop will be Russia. Unprecedented evil going on, ladies and gentlemen. But it's all okay because Obama's black and it's trending. Fund Al-Qaeda to attack Syria for 3 years. Then Al-Qaeda attacks Iraq. Got to take American liberties because of the Al-Qaeda threat. I'm Wolf Blitzer reporting from the Central Intelligence Agency, CNN. All right, I'm going to stop right there. We're talking to the Food Babe right now, foodbabe.com. Annie Hari, and she started it back in 2011 and has had a great effect with her victories, thanks to you out there, our victories across the board. Talk about what you've done with Chick-fil-A, Kraft, Whole Foods, Lean Cuisine, McDonald's, General Mills, Coca-Cola, Chipotle, and many others. I mean, this is really a good tactic you're using. How did you learn and develop all this? And then let's get into the secrets of beer.
Yeah, so, you know, I was like a sick child growing up my whole life. You know, my parents had come here from India, didn't know how to cook American food, and they wanted me to fit in like everybody else. So what did we do? We bought the packaged processed goods at the grocery store that are full of corn and soy and no nutritional value. We ate McDonald's for lunch, for dinner, for breakfast. I mean, I don't know how many Father's Days we went to McDonald's for their free breakfast. I don't know if they still do that or not, but we used to go every single year growing up, and Father's Day is coming up, and it just reminds me of that time period where, you know, if you do like a little coloring for your dad, you get a free, you know.
Totally sick ploy, like crack dealers trying to give crack to 10-year-olds at the playground.
Exactly. And, you know, I grew up that way, and it was so detrimental to my health. I suffered asthma, eczema as a child, never felt well, always had stomach aches, you know. And then when I graduated college and got into the real world and started living this rat race environment, working for a big six consulting firm in a cubicle, traveling, being on their expense account, eating what everybody else was eating around me instead of controlling my own food and controlling my own destiny, I became really overweight. I became very sick very quickly, and I had to have, you know, an organ taken out of my body.
Oh my God.
And doctors will tell you, oh, appendicitis is very random. It can happen to anybody, but I don't believe that. You know, appendicitis happens when your stomach is inflamed from all the stuff that you've been eating or treating your body with. And unfortunately, a lot of people are eating these new industrial food-like substances that are causing this inflammation. And I definitely was a victim of that. And so I decided in that hospital room back in December that of 2002, over 10 years ago now, that I would take control of my own health. I would figure out what's in food, how to eat the best food possible. And what I found out was shocking. Not only did I find out that majority of our food is made with genetically engineered ingredients, never tested long-term on humans, but I found out that all of these substances that are really cheap for the food industry to use are pumped into all of our food. And so I started to reject that. I said, no more corn, no more soy. None of this GMO stuff. I'm going to eat organic food. I'm going to start going to farmers markets. I'm going to find out what these chemicals mean on the back of packages. And when I found out that things like yoga mat material are in there, and things like high fructose corn syrup that, you know, they find mercury in, and how like there's all of these different additives that are used to create addiction to food, like hidden MSG, I knew I didn't need to eat that anymore. And so I shunned all of those brands and companies long ago. And when I did that, something remarkable happened. Not only did I lose weight, but I've been able to maintain a nice figure for a really long time, doing nothing but eating real food. And also, all of my health issues as a child and as an adult magically went away. Alex, I'm talking about being on 6 to 8 prescription drugs, depending upon the season, to being on 0 today. Being 10 years older and having less drugs as a 10 years older and having more energy 10 years older than I did 10 years ago when I started figuring this stuff out. And when I did this, everyone around me, my friends, my family members, they wanted to know the secrets. And so I started to tell them what I learned, and they were shocked. They were downright, they couldn't believe the information I was giving them on a day-to-day basis as I was traveling with them, you know, whether it be coworkers or with friends or family or at my mom's house.
The truth is, they've grandfathered for 100 years. I know you're an expert on this, but we've had other experts on speak about this. I don't get into beer. To be able to basically put drugs in the food. The additives are toxic. Many poisons are addictive. Aspartame, you name it, MSG. They are getting you trained to eat their processed food. And then they have, just like the tobacco companies, adding all these other chemicals to make it more addictive. It's just like tobacco companies, but with food. And
that's right.
And I've read the, you know, the books, the documents, we've covered it, where they brag about that. I mean, as you know, Colonel Sanders made Kentucky Fried Chicken take over because he found out the Japanese military couldn't get Japanese back in World War I to eat the cruddy canned food because Japanese like good fresh seafood. So they learned to put MSG in it. It's totally toxic and tricks the brain. He brought that here in the 20s. The next is history. There's thousands of things they're doing, and here you are exposing it. Let's start getting into beer, the big beer conspiracy.
You know, because I care about the ingredients I buy and I bring in my home, and you can see my refrigerator back behind me, the one thing nothing. I didn't know what was in my fridge because I have a husband and he loves beer, was beer. Like, I would look at the label and I knew nothing about it. And I couldn't believe that I knew nothing about it. And so I started to ask questions. About a year and a half ago, I started an investigation and I started asking the beer manufacturer questions about what's actually in their beer, what ingredients are allowed in beer. And when I found this book published called Chemical Additives in Beer, it's actually out of publishing. It was in 1982 that it was released. So it was so old, but it had this list of additives that are allowed in beer. Things like MSG, things like carrageenan, which is linked to intestinal inflammation, high fructose corn syrup, caramel coloring level 4, which is considered a carcinogen in the state of California.
Yeah, the truth is they, Budweiser especially, it's just beer flavoring, sugar, and some alcohol they squirt in it. A lot of these companies aren't even doing fermentation now. It's not beer.
Right. And they're not even using real hops either. One thing I found out that Miller Coors has patents on this thing called Tetra Hops. It's a hop extract. So it's the minimum amount of hops they can possibly use in beer. And so, like, a lot, there are actually health benefits to eating hops, but they actually take all those out when they start using these extracts. And so there's all of this mystery behind what people are drinking. And people around the world, it's not just Americans, people around the world are blindly drinking beer. And so I wanted to start a petition. I launched it this morning at foodbabe.com/beer, and over 11,000 people have already signed it in less than 3 hours. This is a big, huge issue, and I'm opening up Pandora's box for these beer companies. It's a $100 billion industry, and I'm scared to death right now. You have to have a lot of courage to go up against the beer industry, but someone has to do it. We have to stop this lack of transparency. We have to increase the amount of information consumers have so they can say, you know what, Bud Light Lime has high fructose corn syrup. I'm not going to buy that anymore. I'm going to go to this craft brewer, or I'm going to go to this organic brewer and get something of quality to bring into my home and feed to my husband and my family.
And by the way, as we know, the microbrewers everywhere are now displacing, because people drink it and go, wow, this is beer, versus the toxic stuff that people are trained on. So beer drinkers have to get their friends off of the bad stuff. And just like you go to Target now, 5 years ago, all the ketchup, you know, had fructose corn syrup in it. It had all the bad stuff. Now it openly, you know, says organic. So it's across the board. We were getting the BPA out of the plastic. I think this is going to be even more explosive than your past operations. And I think we're going to force the big beer manufacturers to actually produce beer, because the corporate chiefs don't want to actually have to have brewmasters there and actually have to create good tasting beer. They want to just put a bunch of fake syrup together that tastes like beer and beer flavoring. You know, we want real root beer with real sarsaparilla. We want real beer that actually, you know, is organic and grows well. That's why they're losing such a market share. I saw the number that they've lost like 45%, saw it in the Wall Street Journal last year, in the U.S. of their market to micro and local brewers. The way they counter is to try to buy them up. But you know, no, why don't the...
People realize those microbrews taste better than the watered-down, sugary stuff that they're selling us in the typical, most popular beers, which is, it's really sad that, you know, the most popular beers still continue to be Bud Light and Miller Lite, and it's because it's cheap, and people need to realize that because something cheap is cheap doesn't mean it's good and good for you, but they have such a huge marketing machine. I mean, just think about all the Super Bowl ads and everything else that they do on a normal basis to brainwash you into wanting these brands as Americans. And even people overseas, you know, I don't know how many times I've traveled, Alex, and I come across someone that's from another country and they think it's cool to drink Budweiser. And I'm like, no, you need to be drinking the beer.
No, no, it's crazy. I see all the Mexican immigrants up here and they're all getting Miller Lite and Budweiser. And I'm like, my God, this Mexican beer tastes light years better than the fake New World Order beer. But that's what they want. And then it gives you diabetes.
Yeah, one of the things I want to mention, you mentioned Mexico beer. Well, Corona was actually acquired by one of these big companies, and now they're using propylene glycol, something found in airplane de-icing liquid in Corona. So beware of Corona.
Incredible. I don't like Corona. I used to taste good when I was in high school, and now it hadn't tasted good in a long time. I don't drink a lot of beer. I don't drink a lot anymore, but you know, bottom line is that...
Alex, I think the most interesting part of this story is that right now, the FDA does not regulate beer. The Treasury Department, who controls our taxes, is regulating one of the world's most popular drinks. I mean, it's third after water and soda.
Yeah, where's the FDA when they're harassing people that sell vitamin C pills and shutting them down? But then meanwhile, because the NFL's tax exempt, these big beer companies, they're all left alone.